This is Friday Night Lights with Tim O'Brien. Brought to you by Honda of the Desert.
I'm ready to rock. That's week three. It happened so quickly. We're already at week four. That's Gil Rutenberg, the general manager of Honda of the Desert. Of course, I'm Tim O'Brien. Week four high school football here in the Coachella Valley. It was wet. It was windy. It was a mess
windy.
Out there tonight.
Hurricane.
Yeah, no, that's what it felt like. That's what's happening off the coast. Just between the break here, you had mentioned Keon Lenore, the wide receiver from Coachella Valley.
Yeah.
You challenged him this week.
I did, but he got scared.
Yeah. Gil wanted to race him.
I wanted to race him. He didn't want to.
He didn't want to get embarrassed, that's for sure. Let's get right into it. Obviously, the theme for the night is the wild weather that we've been seeing most of the day, and it's made for some entertaining football. These guys didn't want to throw the ball because the ball is wet, so they kept it on the ground. We can't do it without you, though. That hashtag you see there on your screen, CVFNL, tag us with your photos and videos. Our buddy Michael Walsh, the athletic director at Shadow Hill, sent us some videos because they were on the road tonight up near Riverside. So it all worked out. It's working. It helps when you use that hashtag, the videos and photos.
Hashtag away.
Yeah, CBFNL. No doubt about it. Let's get right into last night's game. We'll recap a little bit. La Quinta played against the Redlands Terriers. All right, so they were looking to bounce back after what happened to them against Coachella Valley.
Yep.
They wanted to go 1-1. Well, the Blackhawks defense started strong. You see number 22, Aaron Caballero, break through the line and sack Redlands quarterback Dawson Martinez. Blackhawks on offense now. You've got sophomore running back Aiden Ensabuga can't handle the toss, and he loses. So there's two turnovers right out of the gate. Gil, there were six penalties in the first quarter from La Quinta last night. First quarter's almost an hour long. Flag after flag, whistle after whistle. It was rough. The next set of downs, though, Redlands quarterback Dawson Martinez fakes the handoff one way, gets it into the hands of Alex Villa, who takes it to the house. Terriers are up 7-0. You could feel the pressure on the sideline at La Quinta last night. Like, not again. They saw what happened to Aaron Ramirez at Coachella, ran it right down their throats. They couldn't convert here on fourth down, so that was another tough break. They were inside the 20, Gil, four different times last night and couldn't score. They went on to lose the game last night. Redlands would win 28-13. Now it's head up the road where the Rancho Mirage Rattlers were looking for their first win of the season as they hosted Norte Vista from Riverside. It didn't start well. This was a team, even the Desert Sun, the newspaper here in town, had Rancho Mirage doing well. Hasn't been their year.
Nope.
Not at all. Not in the slightest. In fact, second play of the game, Vista Norte's Brian Temple takes a run to the house. A 72-yard run gave the Braves an early 6-0 lead. You see him there on the 20, 15, 10,
he's
5.
Gone. He's gone.
Yeah, I would like to see him and Keon Lenore in a race.
And me.
Everybody you see what you're going to put him up against Keon this year. It was 14-0 at the other end. The Rattlers losing after a two-point conversion. Rancho Mirage would fight back, though. You love a little fight in the second half. You've got to be able to show some heart. Quarterback Luke Hirschberger's tip pass caught in the end zone by Zaire Rivas. Conversion no good. Rattlers were down 14-6. As the rain was splashing, you're going to see here in a moment on the camera, Rancho quarterback Luke Hirschberger's pass tipped and intercepted. Not what you want. You're going to see it here in just a moment. This was the condition at one point. And we were talking about it in the newsroom today, Gil. I don't know that you think some of these kids have ever played in rain before.
Man, it's tough.
Unless there's lightning or thunder, they're not going to cancel it.
We don't get that much rain here.
No, not at all. You heard Chloe say there's only 20 storms in the last 70 years have come this close off the coast. But the bottom line is Norte Vista would go on to win 22-6. Rancho Mirage, disappointing season continues. They now fall 0-4.
Gotta get it going.
Yeah, they certainly do. When league play, that's when it counts. They'll be on the road in Ontario next Friday, hoping to right the ship. We've got one more here now. We went to Cat City last minute. So, we got some time.
Check out the Lions.
Show them some love over there at the Lions. I heard the field was almost underwater, almost completely. It was bad. That's how much rain hit that part in Cathedral City, which is unbelievable. But we got a nice run here. Rene Romero from Cat City would tie the game at 20. They showed some heart and some fight today. There was a holding penalty on the Lions, though, negated that play. So it goes back 10 yards from the line of scrimmage. You got to love that they put up a good fight. Coach Lee, I'm sure, was proud of his guys, but the costly turnovers and penalties were the difference. Paris went on to win the game 27-19. Cat City remains winless as well. So you got Rancho Mirage and Cat City 0-8 combined. Not good. Got to turn it around when we play.
Turn it around, Lions.
We got to make a visit, I think.
We do.
Any time that you've gone to a high school, they've won the next week. So
luck of the Honda Desert.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I think it is. We got to check them out. They are winless, and they'll travel to 29 Palms next week to face the Wildcats in the high desert. Just getting started here on Friday Night Lights. We'll feature our game of the week, which was Palm Springs hosting Knight High School out of Palmdale. Could the Indians bounce back after last week's gut-wrenching loss? And coming up next, Palm Desert looking to build on last week's dramatic overtime victory. We're at Azteca Stadium tonight, and we'll show you all the highlights. You're watching NBC Palm Springs Friday Night Lights. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Friday Night Lights here on NBC Palm Springs. Palm Desert back home after they were on the other side of the overtime victory. They had the win last week in overtime. Yeah. Palm Springs on the other end lost in overtime. But both teams, we're going to get to it here in just a moment, saw themselves on the right side of things. They were playing Santiago High School out of Corona, and the Aztecs did not welcome them with open arms today, that's for sure. They were on a mission. The coin toss at midfield. Here we go. Santiago at Palm Desert. Tails never fails, Gil. That's
never.
What they say.
That's what they say.
I think it works like 65-70% of the time. So
at least 50%.
Yeah. I see what you did. Aztecs with the ball to get it going. Brady Klemmer behind center steps back, throws it downfield to someone you don't always see down there. That's the running back, Dimitri Chester, catching the ball in the end zone. Usually he's in the backfield, but he finds some open space, and that's good for a quick six. Aztecs up quick and early. Santiago couldn't get it going offensively. This is a special teams play here, Gil, that you don't always see. It's not easy to do by any stretch of the imagination, but you'll see they come through and block the ball. That thing goes back about 15 yards on the kid's head, the poor guy. I apologize. I couldn't see the number who blocked it, but that's number 42, Zachary Gibbs, who falls on it, scoops it up, runs for the hills. He was down, so that wasn't a fumble on his end. Aztec, though, with the ball, would set him up. It's Brady Klemmer again showing off his arm here in just a moment. He's going to connect with wide receiver Cameron Feast. Look at this arm. It just makes it look so easy.
Too
perfect
easy.
Perfect spiral. Like, I couldn't do that. I'm going to tell you that right now. I couldn't reach. Touchdown, Aztecs just pulling away, and the Aztec faithful are having some fun in the stands tonight. I got to say that between Palm Desert and La Quinta, they might be the loudest fan bases here in the Coachella Valley, from what I've seen early on. So it gets pretty loud.
It does.
Indio wasn't bad. The Indio band was pretty good, too. Aztec pulled away, would go on to win 35-10, improving to 2-1. The Aztecs will travel to Tustin next Friday. Now, the NBC Palm Springs, Honda the Desert, game of the week. We have the Indians of Palm Springs and the Nighthawks out of Palmdale. It amazes me that they let where I'm from, everything's so close.
Yeah.
You don't travel more than like 30 minutes to get to a game. Here, you can drive for hours just to come play somebody. So
travel.
Yeah. Well, they wanted to bring the outside Shadow Hills, Michael Walsh, their athletic director, wants them to play teams outside of Riverside County to see how good they actually are, if they can compete.
Yeah, just get ready for the playoffs.
That's right, for sure. Let's get into it now. Palm Springs coming off that devastating loss. Last week, the Indians were on the verge of winning their overtime game to Eisenhower and Rialto, but that wasn't the case. The Indians were looking to bounce back at home against the Knights, and that's exactly what they did. It was creepy looking. They were able to fall on the ball. This kid tonight, Malachi Whaley, you'll see, jumped on it. This is their running back, number 22. I apologize. I've just skipped his name. Here we go. Francisco Yanez is number 41. Two running backs had back-to-back touchdowns tonight. They figuratively ran away with it. They just couldn't be stopped. Jordan Johnson also punched in two times. Palm Springs was on an absolute mission tonight, Gil. I'm telling you, whoever we pick when it happens, we get lucky. Honda the Desert luck, I'm telling you. You guys have the yellow ribbon on your logo right now for the month of September.
We do.
You need the shamrock. I think we should keep that different logo. They'd go on to win 42-0 tonight. A shutout at home is always special. They'll go on to play Redlands next week up in Redlands. So we'll hear from their head coach coming up, his postgame comments, head coach Dan Murphy, after the break. But up next, we'll introduce you to our Week 3 Players of the Week. We'll see which some players that you gave money to today, or this week, I should say, rather, from Honda the Desert. We had a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, come back. You don't want to miss it. All right, welcome back. I'm not saying this because you're standing right here, but I believe this is the best part of the show.
This.
You come out, you give the fat checks that the kids get to keep. They're so excited. It's so worth it. And this was a good one this week.
It was a lot of fun.
The crowd was there. There was energy. We had a little audience. It was fun. Take a look.
Shut up. Listen up.
Hey, guys. I'm Gil Rudenberg with Honda the Desert. This is Tim O'Brien with NBC Palm Springs. I don't know if you guys have seen the show, Friday Night Lights. You guys were featured on there last week. You guys did a hell of a performance beating those Blackhawks. So round of applause to you guys. Good job. I got some money. Yeah. We got $250 to Offensive Player of the Week. I had to watch them running all over the field. And I got to tell you, if I was out here, I would have caught them. But anyway, let's get Aaron Ramirez, Offensive Player of the Week. Congratulations, $250. Go ahead and spend it on yourself. We'll bring up your teammate up here, Defensive Player of the Week, JJ Miranda. JJ, great job. Heck of a performance. $250 for you. Great job, man. Go enjoy that money. Let's get you guys both together. Let's get a picture. Let's get a picture in front with your team.
That's a lot of fun, man. They were so appreciative.
Great kids.
No doubt about it. They're not in action this week. They'll go back out to Desert Hot Springs, start league play next week. Let's get back out, though, to Ralph Watts Stadium for the coach of the Palm Springs Indian in this week's game of the week.
Feeling good about getting the shutout, but there's a lot of things we got to work on, the personal fouls and the special teams. We need a lot of adjustments and work on that, but I'm happy for the kids. It's the first shutout this year, and just happy for the way they played the game. Offensive line stepped up big tonight, and we had some great performances from Javi Yanez, and a couple freshmen made some contributions tonight, so everyone's happy, but tomorrow morning films, we got to fix some things. Kids had a great week of practice. They told them, you know, it's football. Those things happen, and we got to overcome it. And our character was tested during the week, but the kids showed up, did a great job. Absolutely. They wanted to get back on the right track, and they did that tonight.
Let's take a look now at your Desert Empire League scores around the valley. Palm Springs, 42-10. Palm Desert, 35-0. La Quinta did lose. We saw that. Let's head over to the next division quickly. Desert Valley. Yucca Valley winning. Beaumont up big over Banning. Cat City fell to Paris. 29 Palms is at Rubidoux, I believe. Not a big score there. Before we wrap up, we've got about 15 seconds. Quickly, you're wearing this jersey again for?
I'm wearing this jersey for Childhood Cancer Awareness. September, every Friday, we wear our jerseys at work. But we go gold. We have a gold ribbon. So gold is the Childhood Awareness.
Super important. Gil Rutenberg, Tim O'Brien, thanks for joining us. Have a great weekend.